Hello everyone, this is Virendra back again with a new video of fish processing, preservation and common contaminant from the subject processing technology of fish and marine products. So start with the introduction. Fish are abundantly found in the natural water or the saline water. It's the valuable source of food and has been used for man and other aquatic animals. Fish is a valuable source of high protein, minerals and vitamins. That's why it is used for human consumption as well. Oily fish are rich in omega-3 fatty acids. They are polyunsaturated fatty acids. So next, with the composition of fish. Fish contains water, fat, protein, vitamins with the percentage of 65 to 80%, 1 to 20%, 14 to 20%, 0.8 to 2%. Fish are having the higher moisture content, availability of nutrients is high, and the temperature is quite suitable for the microbial growth. So we'll go into the microbial contamination of fishes. Fishes contamination refer to the spoilage or taint. Attack of the fish is by the undesired microorganisms like bacteria, fungus, yeast, molds, viruses and other toxic elements is due to their external body conditions or the fisherman's handling. So the types of microbial contamination is has been divided into the four. In this slide you can easily visualize this. It's the bacteria, virus, prions and different fungus, algae, protozoa and yeast. So if you talk about the bacterias have been stated into different types like on the basis of the surfaces and the intestinal. If you talk about the skin of fishes, they have Pseudomonas, Micrococcus, Vibrio, Bacillus and there are n number of bacteria as well. And if you talk about freshwater genera of fishes where the freshwater is present, the Streptococcus and Lactobacillus are common bacteria which are generated from these fishes. Rather than if you talk about intestinal, Pseudomonas and Bacillus are more likely to be present. The other sources of contamination are as stated earlier into my presentation, that from water or the saline or the skin of the fishes or from the intestine. And finally, the main source of contamination can be the catching of the fishes from the source they are present. Water contains freshwater bacteria and other tropical bacteria which are mesophilic. Density based or the skin based microbes, as already stated, that it's the surface of the fishes which carries out the bacteria. From intestine, both salt based bacteria, that is the surface bacteria, and the intestinal bacteria are already present for contamination. And the number of bacteria or microorganism can be found on the surface or in the intestine by the handling of different fishermen's or the sources of water. If you talk about from the equipment used for processing, boats, catching nets, boxes, fish house, fishers may contain contaminant and which is passed on to the fishes during the cleaning and during transportation. Contamination of fish may be contaminated due to the freshwater fish has been contaminated with the other contaminated fish all around it. If you talk about contamination of fish in fish processing industries, there are n number of factors which can affect the contamination of fishes. Fish processing instruments like knife is more common, fish collecting ship, fish processing table, pollutant environment, gutting devices, machines, contamination from ice and contaminated fish sources, time of freezing and microbial contaminants may come true as if they are not neat and clean. If we talk about spoilage of fishes, which is one of the topic from contamination or contamination of fishes, it's like food spoilage can be considered as any number of changes in the products is referred as spoilage. We can talk about any external factor which is unfit for the consumption of fishes are referred as spoilage. Spoilage of fish starts upon the death due to the auto-oxidation and reaction by activities of fish with their own enzymes and the metabolic activities of the microorganisms. If you talk about the types of fishes, fish spoilage, it's the microbial spoilage, physiological spoilage, biochemical spoilage, and there are the figures which can state these spoilage. Causes of spoilage are has been stated into different factors. It's like high moisture content, high fat content, high protein content, weak muscular tissue, favorable conditions and temperature, and unhygienic handling. The process of spoilage is starts immediately after the death of fish. The process involves three stages: rigor mortis, autolysis, bacterial invasion, and putrefaction. This complete flowchart will show you that how the fishes have contamination and spoilage. So it starts like how the fisherman has collected the fishes. The blood circulation stops by death of that fish. It's the two phase. Number one is glycogen, ATP falls, and rigor mortis starts. Another way, it's like lactic acid starts degenerating from the body. pH falls and enzyme activation start. Again, it comes to the rigor mortis and autolysis, which invade or influence different microorganisms, and spoilage starts. So different factors influencing the rate of spoilage or kind of spoilage are the kinds of fishes. If in case you are carrying out different kind of fishes during the transportation, it can lead to the spoilage. The condition of fish when caught, whenever the fisherman is doing his activity for getting the fishes to the transportation. So the condition from where he has caught the different fishes, whether the condition is favorable for spoilage. If it is favorable for the spoilage, it will promote the spoilage at higher condition and higher number with the kinds of bacteria and funguses. So next one is temperature and use of antibiotic ice or dipping methods. So there are different evidences for spoilage. We'll go with the evidences, how you can check out whether the fish has been spoiled or not. So color of fish becomes faded, dirty and yellow, in yellowish brown. Slime of the skin increases. The upper surface will be quite sticky. Eyes shrink. Pupil becomes cloudy and cornea opaque. Softening of flesh and anus wet with swallowing swollen and redness will be generated. Meanwhile, a sequence of order will be evaluated. Chemical preservatives. There are a number of chemical preservatives used in the industries of fishes and other food products. One of the common are benzoic acid, sorbic acid, boric acid, and formaldehydes. They can be used as a preservative successfully all over the world. So finally, thank you all for the this safeguarding the nutrition value and making it safe for the eating. We should only go for the preservation techniques, and preservation of fishes is our next topic to be look forward. Fishes can only be consumed in a fresh, not only fishes, if you talk about any of the diets, we should only consume the fresh food for our diet. So preservation methods of fishes are likely. There are plenty of techniques. We'll start with the low temperature technique. For effective preservation, we should go for a lower temperature preservation. Start with minus 40 and maintain it at minus 23 as per approved by ICMR and RDA, which is the recommended dietary alliance authorities. By this method, fishes will stay for 6 to 7 months. The next method is chilling. In the case of chilling, we can we'll cover the fishes by the layer of ice, and this method is more often is not used for the longer period. It's for a shorter period of time where the fishes will be shared into the markets or for the canning factories. Next will be the freezing. Freezing is more effective technique than chilling. Freezing is achieved by using of ice, salt, and refrigeration techniques. It is maintained at minus 30 degrees Celsius, and internal body temperature of fish will be minus 20. So the rancidity will be lower and it can be preserved for a longer duration. Smoking is another method of preservation, where curing will be done within 12 hours, and after 12 hours the re-smoking and roasting will be done. Salted fishes can also be smoked by this method. Salting. Salt is one of the most common preservative agent used for increasing the shelf life of fish or any of the food products. It is almost used in all the methods of preservating, either in the refrigeration, freezing, or else any techniques. So there are many different kinds of salt used for the betterment of fish curry. Last and final is canning. Canning is one of the very efficient method for preservation. It is a very good method of retaining the flavors and nutrition value. Fishes are clean, cut, and then sterilized with variable steams and number of heating methodologies. Chemical preservatives. There are a number of chemical preservatives used in the industries of fishes and other food products. One of the common are benzoic acid, sorbic acid, boric acid, and formaldehydes. They can be used as a preservative successfully all over the world. Thank you for your precious time. We love to have your feedback for improvement. Please like, share and subscribe this channel, Food Quality Lecture Series. Thank you.